So what else have you noticed? I know you've looked through a lot of tape. I know you've been focusing so much on that defense. What else has stuck out with you that maybe you didn't notice a couple days ago?
I mean, it's the same thing. Nothing's changed from a couple days of my mindset on these guys. They run to the ball like crazy. They play with a tremendous amount of effort. It's not like they do anything complicated. They're regular four down defense, two linebacker box. We just got to play harder than them and longer than they do. And if we end up, whatever happens in this game is going to come down to the offensive line of, moving the down guys and, setting the tempo early and just getting off the ball.
What makes it so possible for them to put pressure on with just four guys? They don't have to bring a lot, and they're still able to put pressure.
Because it's not the one move. A lot of teams, when the D lineman gets, when the offensive lineman gets them on their first move, usually they'll just stop and, try to, run to the ball. But these guys have a second and even a third move to get to the quarterback, in particular number eight on the end. Watching film from last year to this year, he's a totally different guy. The entire defense just very well coached and, plays all out with a lot of effort.
You said last week sort of the same thing that Stanford had, second move, third move.
Yeah.
Do you feel like the guys you faced against Stanford sort of give you a good look?
Yeah, it's the same thing. But, I'm not knocking off Stanford at all. But Utah's, I think they're better than Stanford is front seven wise. They just play well together. You could tell they're all playing together. They got a good chemistry out there. And like I said, it's not anything complicated. We just got to get off the ball and play harder and longer than they do.
We talk a lot about the noise that's going to be down there, and communication is going to be a premium. How do you get the calls along the line for a place that's going to be huge?
That's going to be big. That's something we've definitely been focused on a lot this week. With our cadence, we got to make sure we start fast and get the points up on the board early to get the crowd out of it. Because if we start out jumping off sides and getting the crowd into it, it's going to be really hard to get out of a second and long or third and long. So we don't want to be in that situation. But communication has to be on point. The guards and tackles also have to help out a lot. They've been doing a good job of that. So we just got to keep on doing that, keep on working hard.
Hroniss, you guys were so good on the road for so long when you had that 18-game streak last year. Not that you guys really worried about the streak itself, but you just always won. You lost a couple on the road. Do you sense the swagger coming back about playing on the road and a confidence when you go away from the
game? Yeah, we just got to play together because we're out there versus the entire stadium. It's us versus them. And if we stick together, we could take them out of the game early. And that's our mindset going into this game. And that's all it has to be. We don't have to get caught up into all the hype of the game and listen to what their fans are saying, because we expect the fans to call every name in the book. And we just got to focus on our game and execute our game plan.
When you watch the breakdowns of their defensive line against O-lines, do you see common mistakes that other O-lines make against these guys that they seem to always take advantage of? Are there things that you always know, okay, I have to stay away
from? It's having a
this
second and third effort against those guys. That's what it's going to come down to, is playing harder and for longer than they do. That's what a lot of other offensive linemen get caught in trouble with, is letting off the gas pedal when they think they got their guy blocked and they're able to come off the block and make a play on the running back. And that's where we gotta take that as a challenge and really execute it.